Residents in one local town are fired up over how the city controls the pet population. As Monica Lempert reports, city officials are considering new options, but all of them require pet owners to dig deep into their pockets.
Lily Murphy found her dog Doyle roaming the streets of her neighborhood last Thanksgiving.
He had no tags, no chip. We got him into our vet, tried to see if, you know, there was some identification on him, and there was none.
It's an issue that Fort Smith is trying to eliminate. Dogs wandering the streets, neither spayed nor neutered, and without identification.
After talking to vets and different agencies, no one came forward. And by that time, I'd become incredibly attached to him and decided that he'd found the right home.
Doyle is one of the lucky ones, but there are many cats and dogs who don't have a happy ending. The number of animals being euthanized is continuing at a steady flow.
We do unfortunately still euthanize a large number of animals every year at our Humane Society. I don't think, though, that the result is going to come from mandatory spay and neutering. I think the result's going to come from proper education of the public.
The Fort Smith Board of Directors is considering an ordinance requiring pet owners to license and spay and neuter their animals. It's a proposal that could cost a lot of money for pet owners.
If they're going to make that a law, they need to make it affordable for everybody.
The board of directors is looking into how this would affect the community on an economic standpoint, as well as public health. Whatever decision they make, they say it's for the pets' best intentions.
You know, it breaks my heart, especially if they're starving and stuff like that. But, you know, people got to keep them locked up, keep them in a fence, keep them on a chain, keep them in the house. Whatever they have to do, that's your responsibility as a pet owner. It's like, you know, making sure your children don't get bad pull.
Monica Lempert, 4029 News.
And the board is forming a committee that includes veterinarians to review the issue and come up with a proposal that will best work for Fort Smith within the next 30 days.